Okay, we've got another image sent in for us to edit, and this one's sent in by @check. So in the description, go give him a follow, and GoPro featured photographer. So obviously all these photos are taken on GoPro, so you get that wide dramatic look. And we've obviously got a very, very strong orange and teal color grade. And he also has his presets available. So he's got a few bundles here of presets for you guys if you like his style. So we're gonna jump into Lightroom and see if we can create something like this with really bright whites and a really strong orange and teal color grade. So let's get into Lightroom. Okay, so we've got his image from his Instagram, and we've got these big distorted trees from the effect of the wide GoPro shot. So he's used it in a creative way intentionally on that shot. So teal and orange, let's get into it. Just gonna bring that contrast down. Highlights, because I'm gonna be bringing up the whites, so I'll drop the highlights. And we'll run into one problem, that the water has a real green cast to it. So as you can see, the reflection of the trees and the water isn't blue, so it's gonna be very hard to get the teal look, but we will fix that at the end. So don't get too hung up on what the water looks like just yet. Bring out these whites. That's what's gonna get that pop. Then you gotta bring down the blacks to keep a bit of contrast. Clarity, I'm gonna bring down a lot, especially just for now, because GoPros can be quite sharp. I'm gonna bring up the vibrance and saturation. Vibrance affects more of the midtones. And curve, tiny little fade. Okay, so I think our contrast is looking pretty good now, and onto colors. Before I actually do anything here, I'm gonna come down to this camera calibration. So that's gonna really help us. It's gonna do most of our colors, is shifting the blue primary. I'm just gonna desaturate it a tad. Now I'm gonna work with some colors in the HSL. So I might keep the oranges about there. These yellows I'm gonna bring a long way. Greens I'm gonna really warm up. We want those teal blues, but our water still looks really green, but we'll fix that later. Saturation. These yellows are gonna really make the biggest difference. Bring them down. Really bring the greens down. There's no purples and magentas in this image, but I'm just gonna bring them down around the other ones. Now luminance, how bright we want our colors. Deepen some reds. Now this yellow should make a really big difference. And when we bring up the oranges, you can see how this is affecting the path, making the path really nice and bright. Gonna go about there. Greens I'm gonna bring up. And that's going to be done for HSL. So on to split toning, I think just a little bit in the highlights. Just a little bit of blue. And working our way down. If we enable profile corrections, it's going to try to get rid of that distortion. But obviously the intended effect was to get that distortion. GoPro Hero 5 Silver Edition was what was used. But now, you see our blues in the water look terrible. The rest of the image is looking pretty good. So we're going to come up here to our brush and we're going to take down the temperature. And we're going to brush the water. And I know to brush the water because when you zoom in on his image, this branch here is very blue, and if we go back to our original image, as you can see, it's very green. So I know he's brushed over the water trying to make it look more blue because we had such a green cast to it earlier. So temperature down, and we're just gonna brush away pretty much everywhere. I suspect you use Photoshop, but I just try to show you guys as much as I can in Lightroom. So we can't choose our exact blue with temperature. It gives us a pretty good blue, but if we want to change our color, we just did a little, come down here and we can fine tune that color to exactly what we want. So I'm going to add, so up for saturation, cross for color. I'm going to go about, okay, so I found a color I like, 40 temperature and a bit of darker blue added in there. So now we are done. And if it did have natural blues in it, we still would get that nice teal color because that's what color that lady's bag is going. So that bag is starting off teal. And it's going even more teal, so that we had that very green cast to the water. So how did he get rid of these people? He took it into Photoshop and probably used the clone stamp tool. So we are finished in terms of the colors and brightness of this image. Before, after. So for those people that want to know how to get rid of these people, come up here to help, type in Photoshop, edit in Adobe Photoshop. Okay, that brings us right into Photoshop, and the first thing you want to do is duplicate your background layer, and we're going to work with 100 opacity, 100 flow, and probably about 70 hardness, so that will affect the feathering. And obviously opacity and flow affect the density or amount of the effect. So clone stamp tool, press Alt, select this bit of ground here and place it where you want. Might make it a bit bigger. I'm gonna do this very quickly and not very good at all, but just to show you what you can do. Essentially picking one bit up and placing it over another. can get very picky with it. I'm just trying to show you guys the skills rather than perfection. So Alt, select that bit, place it there, and then you can just spend a bit of time smoothing it up. So you might want to make it a bit bigger. Now you might want to drop the opacity and then just try to blend things a bit better. Make it look a bit more natural instead of a whole lot of little circles. And very quickly done. It looks a little fuzzy back there, but I think it looks alright. So, thanks for watching, guys. That's about it. Go give him a follow. His links will be in the description. And yeah, comment down below who you guys want me to do. Thanks for watching. Catch you in the next one.